Hello and welcome to the channel. I'm Ominous and today we'll review the fifth studio album by the solo artist Eric Clapton, the solo guitarist. As you guys may know, I'm not a huge Eric Clapton guy. I actually reviewed this album, I think, 1 or 2 weeks ago, but, you know, the review, you know, was gone or didn't save, so I had to record it again. I was running low on requests, so I was like, yeah, you know, this was requested by Steven Young together with some other albums. So, you know, he basically looked on like Rolling Stone's list of like greatest albums, and this was on there, of course, because Rolling Stone loves Eric Clapton for some reason. I don't get it personally. This album came out in 77, if I didn't say it already, so it's like, you know, a classic rock album. It's really bland, it's just like the genre rock. It's so straightforward. It's such a fucking bland album, I would say, you know. I don't think that anyone would disagree with me on that part, so. Yeah, you know, as you guys may know, I'm not a huge Eric Clapton guy. I don't hate him, but I definitely think he's one of the most overrated artists ever, in my opinion. He's really not that good on the guitar, to be honest, and his songs overall just fucking bore me, so. Yeah, this album is 39 minutes long, 6 seconds. We have 9 tracks from there, so at least it's consistent in some way. But, yeah, you know, for the most part, it's just very bland. Hold on for a bit, my fucking cat is on the fucking table, which I don't like. On the kitchen table, so there you go. So, yeah, we have the first song, which is Cocaine, of course. I'm not a huge fan of this song. It's really just bland songwriting, you know. Do 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 cocaine. That's essentially the whole song, 3.5 minutes long. There's nothing wrong with this track necessarily, but I just don't fucking care for it. And this is actually not even written by Eric Clapton, it's written by JJ Kill. And I've no idea who that is. Oh, John Kill of the Velvet Underground. So, this is not even a fucking Eric Clapton song. It's like one of his biggest hits. Go fucking figure. Now we have Wonderful Tonight, which I didn't really care for. Really cheesy, bland songwriting. The direction of the song was really tasteless or just very bland, very grey. Just fucking boring songwriting, you know. It's cheery, it's upbeat, but it's so fucking, like, pandering. It's such a generic song. Such a generic song, fucking hell. And then we have Lay Down Sally, even more pandering. Basically just the same as Wonderful Tonight, but just a bit more bubblegum pop in a way. Not necessarily bubblegum pop, that was kind of the wrong word there. Just more pandering, I think. It's more of the same with Wonderful Tonight, whereas Cocaine was, you know, it at least had some kind of Velvet Underground, some kind of impact, and I'm not even that big of a Velvet Underground guy, but at least it had some element of a good band in there, but you know, even with Lay Down Sally, it's just like a fucking copycat of Wonderful Tonight, and even that's some kind of blow, so there you go. Now we have Next Time You See Her, and yeah, this is essentially just the same song, just with a different title, so these are pretty much all the fucking same. Number 5 was We're All The Way, which was kind of like a pointless filler song. It's 2.5 minutes long. Oh, don't climb on the fucking consoles, man. It's 2.5 minutes long. It didn't, like, it was a really underwhelming closing song for me. It just didn't do anything. It was just really, really pointless, really redundant, you know. Which, you know, everything that Eric Clapton already did, he just pretty much rehashed it on this song, which is 2.5 minutes long. It's fucking pointless, so. Nothing good to be found here. Then we get, you know, we go from the shortest fucking track to the longest fucking track, The Core. And this track fucking drags. This track drags me to the fucking core, if you know what I mean. Nearly 9 minutes long. A nearly 9 minute Eric Clapton song. Are you fucking kidding me? I have no idea what to say about this song. This song is really fucking bland. It's really just bland, rudimentary. I don't think that anyone wants a fucking 9 minute fucking Eric Clapton song, nearly 9 minutes long. I think I should leave it there, really. Like, what can I fucking say about this song? It's fucking trash. May You Never. Yeah, I don't fucking know what to say about the song. It's essentially just We're all the Way Again, but it just sounds like a fucking demo tape to me. The second side really takes a nose off, I would say, and just really just kind of rehashes the first side again, but you know, it's basically sounds shittier, the production is more shit, so do whatever what you will. Mean Old Frisco, the songwriting on this track is absolutely atrocious. Arthur Crudup wrote this song, who is from, who the fuck is Arthur Crudup? He died in 74, so Arthur literally wrote the song for Eric Clapton in like in 74, maybe in his fucking deathbed, and then in 77 Eric Clapton released it for himself. Or maybe it's a cover, maybe it's a cover song, I don't fucking know, but it sounds just as boring as any other Eric Clapton song to me. It just sounds, you know, really outdated. It sounds really just, yeah, that's essentially it though. It's just a fucking outdated song which I don't really give a shit about. So yeah, it just sounds so, you know, just dated. I think you've heard me by now. It's just such a dated song. And then we got Peaches and Diesel, which was I don't even know what to say about the song, to be honest. It's, you know, written by Eric Clapton and Albi Galuten. I don't even know who that is. Who is Albi Galuten? I have no idea. He wrote it songs for the Bee Gees. For a lot, yeah. I believe he's a Bee Gees member, I'm pretty sure. Isn't he? Or did he just wrote a lot of Bee Gees songs? I guess he's just like a pop writer, I guess. And he writes a lot of Bee Gees tunes, so. And he's still alive, so there you go. He's really fucking old, though. But this song was a bit more upbeat, I would say. If I would have a favorite of the album, this would probably be it. But, you know, I can't really do that because the title is fucking disgusting. Peaches and Diesel. Like, who wants that? Who wants peaches in their diesel or diesel in their peaches? It doesn't make any fucking sense. This title is kind of gross. But I do enjoy peaches and diesel. You know, it's not bad to smell that, but it smells light. What the fuck? But, you know, that's kind of it, honestly. But, you know, together they're fucking disgusting. So there you go. Yeah, so overall, this album is balls. I don't enjoy Eric Clapton. I don't like this. It's really bland. It's very just one note. It's kind of like the Eagles in a way, but just less offensive. It's just, you know, Eric Clapton is basically the Eagles for me. But, you know, inoffensive. He doesn't offend me. But nothing is fucking happening. It's so fucking boring. So that's kind of it, honestly. My rating for this album is going to be a 4.8. I don't enjoy Eric Clapton, but if you do, let me know in the comments. Do you love this album? Do you hate this album? Let me know in the comments down below. Like or subscribe channel for YouTube Life is One. Let me know what you think about Eric Clapton. I don't, you know, I don't hate the guy, but I just don't get him. He's so fucking boring. So there you go. No other things you just said, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.